Oh my word, I've never seen this.
It's almost like he's...
David!
Sorry.
I'm now going right into the war, right into bomber planes flying straight overhead and bombing this place flat.
Oh, sorry. Oh, the face of a man with a long... Why, is that what you've got? Please don't tell me it is. Something. Did you hear that?
I can hear it again.
It is again.
Yeah. And again.
Oh! What? Something's literally just been thrown and it's just hit my ear.
Someone just grabbed my ass!
Well, it wasn't me, I can assure you.
Welcome to Most Haunted Live, our third and final night from right here at the New Theatre Royal in Portsmouth, and a very warm welcome to viewers on FTN joining us for the first time tonight. What a weekend we have had. Would you agree?
Yes! Yes!
It has been fantastic. We were at Wimmering Manor on Friday. Last night we were at Southsea Castle, which was incredible, and we conducted, for the first time in television history, an experiment involving filtering out extraneous influences and distractions from a psychic. We buried Ian Shillitoe alive with Carl Beattie. They are coming up very soon to fill us in on their amazing experiences. And tonight we will be at the Royal Marines Museum on the Portsmouth seafront. Before the investigations get underway, let's say hello to Yvette Fielding and her fantastic team of investigators. Hello, Yvette! How are you doing?
Hello, Paul. Hi, how are you doing? How's everybody in the audience? Hello to you. We're actually here outside the Royal Marine Barracks, ready to start our investigation. I've got David and Steve Parsons with me now. How are you feeling?
Apprehensive, but really excited.
Are you? What about you, Steve?
Fine, looking forward to it.
All right, let's crack on. We're going to crack on, Paul, straight away and with the investigation as we walk through the front door here. We've got the whole crew with us. We've got Stuart on camera. Say hello.
Hello, everyone. Hi, guys.
And the rest of the crew actually waiting for us in this amazing building, completely different from the last two locations that we've investigated. Kath and Richard Felix is here, Ian's here as well. Carl obviously is actually back in the studio with Ian Shillitoe, so he'll be joining us later on. So I'm relying on you straight away for you give me your... No pressure then. Straight away to give me your first thoughts and feelings as you walk through the door.
Very first thing I feel is a host. I've got someone who has come down from the staircase here. So he's come down the staircase. He looks very much to me like a military steward, and I know them very well because I was one. Mm-hmm. Wasn't Royal Marine, obviously, but I was in the Royal Navy, so very similar. So, you know, they would probably disagree, I should say, the Royal Marines. This guy, white gloves, very smart uniform, looks more to me older and civilian, though, in his... He doesn't feel like a Royal Marine. He feels like he's working for Royal Marines. Probably, if I'm being honest, quite recently, this may be someone who has crossed over within the last 20, 25 years. He's very courteous, and he's taking us this way.
OK, we'll go right in here.
So the team are being led away by a rather courteous ghost. We're going to have updates throughout the evening. We have our webcams throughout the Royal Marines Museum. And as promised, let's welcome them back for their amazing experience, their very dangerous experience last night underground. Ian Shillitoe, our medium, and Carl Beattie, our investigator. Come on out, guys. It was an astonishing night last night, and just one thing I must ask you, Ian, is You said very early on, and Carl kind of conveyed it to us, that you were getting kind of floods of information, of messages, of experiences. Had anything like that, with that kind of depth of experience, happened to you before as a medium?
Never on that level, no. It was solid bam, 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 bam. Almost, I couldn't even begin to start to try and explain what these images were. But I think one of the reasons why that happened, I think they happen automatically anyway, but I think because we had all the exterior noise taken away, I could tune into it a little bit more.
Okay, now, for you, Carl, it was, I would imagine, almost doubly pressured. You had the panic button near you. You also were talking to me and hearing what was going on up here, and you had to talk to Ian. Did his mood seem to change? Were there any physical changes in him? Did you get the sense that he was kind of being almost battered by messages?
Well, Ian, by nature, is a very calm person anyway. So, and we've been speaking about this for the last few weeks, about this experiment and how we're going to do it and how we're going to feel. So when we laid in there and we actually went down, it was just very quiet and quite solemn, wasn't it? There was this... I mean, the biggest shock was the first... sort of dirt going onto the top of the coffin.
From your beautiful wife Yvette, of course.
Yeah, thanks for that.
With some vigour.
Yeah, apparently so.
Okay, well, it was an amazing night. It was a television first. These two guys were buried alive for over 2 hours under 3 tons of earth. Let's remind ourselves what happened last night. Here we go. So there's that massive coffin being lowered in there. There's Yvette looking genuinely frightened. This is a TV first for Most Haunted Live.
Okay, there is a spirit energy around us.
There is?
Yeah. I'm now going right into the wall, right into bomber planes flying straight overhead and bombing this place flat. And I'm actually seeing them shoot literally straight off the sea. And it's actually quite horrific. I can hear it again.
It is again.
Yeah. And again.
Hello. Oh, well done. Now, it's inevitable, the one we show you highlights, it almost looks like a stunt, but it was a very serious experiment, and I think it's been justified by the amount of stuff you got, which kept our historian, Leslie Smith, beavering away overnight. There was so much going on down there. Is it something you'd like to do again? Here.
I'd probably say yes.
Oh, yeah.
I think so. I mean, it was just, maybe, you know, other psychics do it as well, because I just think, you know, obviously, as I said before, it's a very, you know, it's a very serious experiment. Don't do it at home without, I mean, there's lots of, you know, professional people looking after us and stuff, but it's a very, very interesting experiment. Or another form, another take on it, maybe.
Now, you're very used to, I suppose, meditating is the word, because of your martial arts training, because of actually kind of being so focused. Did you feel more focused down there than you would say when you were training or in the dojo or something? Were you more into yourself, if that makes sense?
It was kind of a difficult thing because, as you said, you know, I was kind of trying to listen to you and talk to you and concentrate what was going on. I couldn't sort of get into a meditationary state as such. But there was one point when we lost the feed, and literally we had nothing, absolutely nothing. We had no feedback, no talkback. Everything had gone, and it was just this quiet place, and it was almost like a dreamland for about 2 or 3 minutes. It's weird.
It was very tranquil. The whole place was just, it actually felt quite comfortable at one point, which is really, really surreal.
Okay, we're going to talk more about that later on, and I think it's inevitable we will repeat that experiment for the moment. Thank you, Ian and Carl. Carl, I know you've got to get off to join Yvette and the gang. Carl Beattie, Ian, staying with us. Now, while Carl makes his way to the Royal Marines Museum, we're going to share with you why we think this particular venue merits our attention. Let's take a look.
The Royal Marines Museum is based at the former Eastney Barracks on the Portsmouth seafront and is housed in what were the magnificent officers' quarters. It is now custodian to an amazing collection that celebrates the illustrious history of the regiment. Not only is it the guardian of all 10 Victoria Crosses awarded to the Marines, but it is also reputed to be the home of several spectral beings. Tales abound amongst the staff of burly ex-Marines who would rather face the rigours of service than wander the museum alone in the dead of night. Tonight, we'll try to put some names and numbers to those hazy apparitions.
the venue. Our investigators are braving as we speak. We've been joined by one of our experts tonight, Dr. Kieran O'Keefe. Hello, Kieran.
Good evening.
Now, have you changed your view about last night's experiment? I know you thought that Ian was very brave. You weren't overly impressed with the results, were you?
No. Again, both Carl and Ian were very brave. The results, for me, evidentially, some of the messages that came through, no, vague and ambiguous. But I was watching also psychological symptoms and maybe physical symptoms that would, you know, I thought might be panic, that sort of thing. So it's a fascinating night.
Now, Ian, I know you were particularly incensed by two things that Kieran said. One was this idea that you panicked. You said you had a tingling sensation, so did Carl. And Kieran said that was one of 13 indicators you were heading for a panic attack. That's all it was, mate. Nothing occult.
Well, I don't think I was. I mean, when I was younger, I used to get panic attacks, and that wasn't any part of it. And I know when a panic attack comes on, I know how you feel prior to a panic attack. That's slightly chemical imbalance that you can get. And the tingling, to me, as working as a psychic, working as a medium, is my calling card.
Yeah, but at the end of the day, there are 13 symptoms, and you may have had panic attacks before, but you need four of them for it to be a genuine panic attack. And you could have had any of those before. It's just in this particular state, in a coffin where you've never been before, you had those tingling
sensations. He was smiling, though, Kieran. He said he felt placid and tranquil. He wasn't
panicking.
Yeah,
but let me finish. At the end of the day, right, from my perspective as a psychologist, when you look at the symptoms, there are 13 of them. You could have had any number of symptoms. I wasn't saying you had a panic attack, but you certainly had one of the symptoms. And that was, at the end of the day, may have been concern for you.
Yeah, well, I wasn't concerned at all, actually. I was very excited about the whole event, and panic was miles and miles away.
OK, this discussion is going to continue, because I want to hear more from you two guys. For the moment, thank you to Kieran O'Keefe and Shillitoe. As we go interactive, we are now going to hear from the man who's always at the cutting edge, with his ears to the ground, Julian Clegg.
Thanks, Paul. Good evening, good evening. Great to have you there. And good evening from everyone on Interactive, because they're already buzzing down on the computer screens just below us here in the theatre. Now, we want you to get interactive as ever. We want you to go to our website, livingtv.co.uk. Our webcams are up and running now, and we want you to look at them and tell us what you see. Let's have a look at the webcams right now. Webcam 1 is on the stairs leading to the first floor picture gallery. Webcam 2 in the Education Centre in the North Wing. Webcam 3 is in the ground floor corridor at the heart of the building. There it is there. And webcam 4 is in a room on the top floor. Now, I want you to look at those. If you see anything unusual, any paranormal activity, let us know. This is how you can get in touch, obviously through the website. You can text me, text 83088, starting your message haunted, then a space, then MSG, and then don't forget to tell me what your message is and where you are and where you're from. Also, fax me, the fax number, 0239 273 9495. We'd like to get your psychic art as well on that fax number. Now, your photo messages. These have been incredibly popular over the last two nights. Let's have some great ones again tonight. If you see something spooky at home, or you've got an orb in a picture you took on holiday, anything like that, I want to receive your photo messages. Here's the number, 07725 203049. They cost 50p. You must be over 18 to send a photo message, by the way, and do get permission from whoever's in a picture, because they might land up on the telly a little bit later on. Lots of details on that on our website, livingtv.co.uk. okay, now let's move on to our competition tonight. Another great prize this evening. Two winners could drive off with an absolutely amazing prize tonight, folks. We're giving away two brand new Peugeot Luddix Snake scooters. Yeah, very nice. If you'd like to win these, all you have to do is answer this question. By the way, runners-up will get the new Most Haunted Live 4 DVD, signed by all the crew, so that's worth having as well this evening. Here's the question. What is the name of the famous ship that sank near Portsmouth? Was it A, Mary Lily, B, Mary Daisy, or C, Mary Rose? Let me know. Call right now, 09015 339910, or if you're a digital satellite viewer, press your red button right now. It costs £1 to do that, and you must be over 18 to enter. And the lines close at midnight. We'll talk to the winner of those lovely scooters on our Your Say show after midnight. More from Interactive a bit later on, but for the moment, Paul, back to you.
Thank you, Julian. We're going to take the shortest of short breaks now. When we return, Yvette Fielding and the gang will be deep inside the Royal Marines Museum in Portsmouth. Don't miss it. Back in a moment. Paris Haunted Live and our final night in Portsmouth. Let's go straight back to the Royal Marines Museum, where Yvette and the team are in mid-investigation. How are you doing, Yvette?
We're okay, we're doing fine, thanks very much, Paul. And we've come into one of the first main rooms. It's an actually beautiful room, it really, really is. And the whole building has a great atmosphere about it. As I said before at the beginning of the show, it has a totally different atmosphere to the other locations that we've already investigated. So I think tonight, I don't know whether David can say whether I'm right or wrong, it's a whole new different feel, different feeling, different sort of vibes. The atmosphere is totally changed.
It is here. What I really don't want, though, is people lulled into false sense of security. Because as I'm walking around here, I'm aware of further up the building.
Right.
That there could be something quite not right. It doesn't feel as pleasant.
What do you mean? A particular spirit person that doesn't want us here? The usual that we sometimes get?
Well, I'm not sure about that. What I've been aware of, this is quite clearly a social space. Mm-hmm. Drinking, eating, enjoying yourself, mess dinners, etc., etc. But, you know, I like to tune in and get past the residuals. Now, I've got our little friend who's shown us around.
This is the gentleman that you picked up coming down the stairs. Now, what happened there? What happened there outside?
What?
Did you see that, Stuart?
Somebody just got crap, just came down the stairs.
What is it?
It's a 10-pence piece.
It's a 10-pence piece.
I assume it's that.
Did it come down the stairs?
You saw it, didn't you?
Someone just came down there.
You were here, did you see it?
No, I didn't see it, I just heard it come down. If it is that. It'd
be more impressive if it was an old coin.
Mm.
Now...
I don't know.
What do you think to that?
I don't know. I thought it was something else, I thought it was...
We all heard it from in there.
It sounded like it hit the banister when it came down.
Well, can we not rewind the webcams? Because if that's got a shot down here,
yeah,
you might see something happening.
Yeah, I don't know if Paul and everybody in the studio can, if we can do something, maybe have a look on the webcam, see if we can see something flying through there. They're actually looking back now, I've been told. Now, another thing that's happened, two things. First of all, to let you know that Carl is with us as well. He's joined the investigation, which is great. Secondly, when we first came in here, David actually mentioned that he saw sort of a military-type gentleman that was sort of present and coming down the stairs. Then, Kath mentioned that she had actually seen something on the stairs. What did you see?
When I walked in here, I was just looking round, and I saw at the corner of my eye a figure just walked past the window, and the curtains were moving, the net curtains, and I kind of said to one of the guys, did you see that? I said, yeah, that's one of the stories. I didn't know that at all. So okay. That was interesting.
All right. So this gentleman that you mentioned in the room that we've just come out from, he's here.
Yeah, he's a guy, but the point I'm trying to make and why I'm concerned is, getting past the residuals, there is another character that was wandering around here. He's presenting, I'm not suggesting he was like this in life, but he's doing it for a reason. He's presenting as unshaven, dark rings, worried, crouched, hunched, and looking like, you know, they look like this.
Oh, gosh.
So they look at you. And this is in my astral vision. He looked specifically at me like this.
Oh, right.
And then went up.
Okay.
So that's a warning. That's a kind of like, see you later.
Who's upstairs?
Steve Palmer.
Okay, all right, fine. Shall we go up the stairs?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, let's follow him.
Are you all right, Stu? Are you okay going backwards up the stairs, or do you want to follow us?
No, I'm fine.
All right. So, I can't quite believe that we've actually already had, this coin thrown down at us. Now, these two gentlemen that you've actually come up with, do you have any names for them yet? I know it's early.
Yeah, it's early. Not yet.
Okay.
The older gentleman is calling me sir.
Okay.
So, and he would call you mom. He's very respectful.
This is the first gentleman on the
stairs.
Very first
one. Other one's gone. The other one's gone and he's waiting.
Okay. What time period are we talking about? From looking, maybe can you see their clothes?
I think
So no name yet, but some intriguing indications already, including, with that tossed coin, possible poltergeist activity. Remember, you all have an opportunity to get involved. Here's Julian Clegg to tell you how. Julian.
Thanks, Paul. Now, we're going to run a psychic art experiment tonight. Now, this is always interesting. We want you to think about the spirits that may haunt the Royal Marines Museum. I've got some pictures, which I'll show later, of some people that may well do haunt the Royal Marines Museum. Then we'll compare your psychic art
with the pictures. That's later in the show. So if you've never done this before, grab a piece of paper, pen or pencil, clear your mind. This is how it's supposed to work. And then maybe come up with a drawing or a figure of a spirit that haunts the Royal Marines Museum. Then when you've got that picture, how do you get it to me? Well, you can fax 0239 273 9495. Okay, that's the fax number. Or you can take a picture, a photo picture of the drawing, and then send it to us on this number, 07725 203049. Those photo messages cost 50p, and you must be over 18 to send those in, and then we'll compare and contrast later on in the show. So as many psychic art drawings as we can get, the better. Also, text your ideas to our text number, Haunted Space MSG. The number is 83088. And don't forget your name and where you're from. Those cost 50p as well. Lots of reaction already on the webcams. Thank you for all that. Lots of text, by the way, saying what happened to Access All Areas tonight. Thank you for all those messages from FTN and Living Viewers. We had a bit of a technical problem, but don't worry. Access All Areas will return on our summer solstice spectacular in June, I can promise you. But for the moment, Paul, back to you.
Thank you, June. Summer solstice spectacular. You nearly sprayed the camera there. You're watching Most Haunted Live on our final night from Portsmouth. We're going to take a break and a breather. We're going to be back with Yvette and the gang after this. Welcome back to the final night of Most Haunted Live from the home of the Royal Navy, right here in Portsmouth. And it's time now to find a volunteer to join our gallant band of investigators and Yvette Fielding at the Royal Marines Museum. One member of this audience is going to be our volunteer, our guinea pig for the evening. They're going to join Ian Shillitoe at the Royal Marines Museum. Let the spotlight pick that lucky person. Who's it going to be? I can't see the spotlight. Where is it? It is Julie Stalinan from Leeds. Where are you, Julie? There she is. And Ian Shillitoe is going with you, Julie. Hang on for him. Good luck, mate. Safe journey. After that, you're on your own. Okay, Ian and Julie from Leeds are heading over there. Let's go straight back to the Royal Marines Museum and Yvette Fielding to find out what is occurring. And I wonder if we have a name yet. Back to you, Yvette.
Thanks, Paul. We're actually still at the same location that you left us in. We've sort of decided to stay here. Again, another sort of big meeting room. Now, you've also picked up on the fact that there's a woman here as well.
Yeah, she's more of a ghostly image. This is... I'm trying to interact with her, and I can't. Staircase... white gown, and I think she's just a replay that people might see every now and again. She's not interacting, she's just standing, fading. Okay. Nothing from her.
Now, Steve, interestingly, you came up here and straight away you had something going on with your EMF.
Yeah, over by one of the windows, we're actually measuring static electricity, and I am getting some unusual readings.
What does that mean in your...
It means that there's a lot of static electricity around, but it's fluctuating, the levels are back to zero now.
So that could... If they were to stay at zero, that could affect us, make us feel things.
It could indeed. We'd feel being touched and stroked, for example.
Oh, right, OK. Right, let's move on. Anything else that you're picking up in this room, or should we just carry on and go straight through here?
Yeah, I want to carry on. I think this, for me, doesn't seem that active, to be honest.
This particular
little,
room?
It's just this little room here.
OK. Now, this is a completely different area. The sort of musical instruments in cases and things like that.
The Royal Marine bands and stuff.
Okay. Do you want to go straight through?
Yeah, I want to go straight through because I'm picking up on kiddies. And I don't know quite why, because they seem completely out of space. Do you know what I mean? They seem...
Yeah, that would be a bit unusual.
Yeah, absolutely. They seem really out. And they're just running around, scampering around.
How many?
There's a good two or three. A good two or three of them.
How old?
They're about between five and seven.
Mm-hmm. And would they have...
I mean, I think, you know, because this presents itself to me like a wardrobe mess. It's kind of what I'm used to, really. Mm-hmm. But it feels maybe that at some time it was residential for officers rather than EMS tech, so therefore families would have been here.
Okay.
This room is... It's very difficult, this room, because these medals clearly hold energy mm-hmm. and memory. I mean, every single one is a story, is it not?
Yeah. You know?
And that's just all I get here, is that emotion. And I suspect when people come through here and they realise that, they also pick up on the emotion. That I have no former... I have no one, like, reaching out to take their medal and pin it on them. Do you know what I mean? I have no former owners of these medals. Mm-hmm. And I think some of them are probably living, to be honest. But the ones that aren't, I have no link to them okay. at all. Might be different if I held them, but nothing at all.
David, obviously these medals mean a great deal to their owners. Mm, would the medals themselves store some of the residual energy of that emotional attachment?
Only depend on how long they wore it, how long they held it. Do you know what I mean? How long they possessed it. Some are posthumous, nothing at all. It's a piece of cloth and a bit of metal.
Okay, you know. Let's move on through, yeah? I love the fact that as we go further on with this particular location, it gets darker and darker and the atmosphere sort of changes into each and every room that you go into. Now, what we want is activity.
Hi. This is the first point right now that I've started to feel threatened.
Threatened by who?
Just try to get under there. Okay, I'm going to play this game.
What?
What was that?
What?
Something banged over there. Did you not hear it? It's like,
no.
I thought it was the cable, but the cable's not.
No.
The cable's behind us. Okay. Right. The Royal Navy, the Royal Marines, people perceive them as the same thing, and to a certain degree they are. I was in the Royal Navy. Royal Marines and sailors have this thing. As soon as a Royal Marine gets on board a ship, they suddenly become soldiers. And as soon as a Royal Marine, don't hit me for this, gets ashore, they become sailors. Mm-hmm. Because they become cantankerous, they like. And this one individual is picking on the fact that I was in the Navy. So therefore, he's insulting me because I was in the Navy.
Well, what's he saying?
He's threatening.
Tell me what
he's saying. He's just basically saying, booties, which I would call them, are better than matlos sailors. But I want to come a bit closer, because this one does stomp around. This one stomps around.
I can't.
This.
No, I was trying to get through to there because I've seen... is there somebody through there?
No.
I was trying to get past Stuart to have a look.
Is there anyone here?
No.
No.
I clearly thought somebody move across here.
No. He's presenting it full back.
Well, did anybody hear that?
Yeah.
That was like an owl,
Yeah, they're not picking us up now. We've gone too far up there, too far into the radio. But I saw someone in there earlier.
You did?
Yeah.
Just heard. Can they hear us now? We're okay
we're
now.
Here.
Just heard twice. Did everybody hear it?
Yes.
Did you hear it, John?
Yes.
Okay. Did you hear it, Carl, Stuart?
I definitely heard it.
Yeah. And also, I heard right behind me like a rustling noise.
I heard that.
You did.
Mm.
Describe to me who this man is.
He's wearing full battle dress. He's got camouflage on, he's got the green beret on, and he's wearing full battle dress and ready for a fight. That's how he appears to me, absolutely ready for a fight. Now, he hasn't died here. He's not died here at all, but this one has come back here because he's familiar. I think he feels very... no family, not... do you know what I mean? The Royal Marines... everything to him, absolutely everything in his life.
I need you to give me an initial or a name or a rank or some information that Leslie can back us up with.
I don't think he's an officer.
Uh-huh.
Right, I'm getting his first name, it's just a simple name, it's Billy.
Mm-hmm.
The surname is harder. Surname I'm having a real problem getting. Obviously, that's the important thing. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Give it to me. No, he's laughing at me. He's laughing at me. He's just taking the pee.
Is he?
Playing games.
But why is he here? Why is he so angry?
He's angry at me.
Why? Because you were...
Because I'm a matlow. Yeah.
Because you're a what?
A matlow, a sailor.
Okay.
He's angry at me. Doesn't seem to be bothered by anyone else.
What time period is he from?
I would think he is probably around, again, quite young, 50s, 1950s, so it's not, you know...
And how old is he?
I'd say when he crossed, he was probably about 35.
Okay, and how did he die? Are you picking up on that? In battle, or...?
No, accident. I would say it was an accidental death, and it was an explosion, explosive accidental
death. In this country?
In this country and around here.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I would say it was around here, accidental death.
I really need to push you for a surname or an initial of a surname.
Billy. I would go for W.
Billy W. Billy something like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, okay. I would go for W.
Do you want to call out for him?
Oh, hang on a minute. Sorry, I just saw...
What?
I just saw something move right across behind Steve again. I know we can't go for Sam, but... This is the cable on the floor.
Yeah, it could have been. Do you want to call out, David?
Yeah.
Seeing as we keep seeing this, don't we, flitting here. If he doesn't like you, maybe you can be angry with him and say,
okay.
Look, come on.
If there's any astrals here, any astral of a Royal Marine called Billy, if you want an argument with a matlow or an ex-matlow, then do something. Do something in the room. Personally, I've had nothing but respect for the Royal Marines. I don't have any argument with the Royal Marines at all. In fact, a great respect for them. What's that? It's outside. I know it's probably only light-hearted. Doesn't seem like it on occasions. But if you want to make a sound in the room. Let us know you're here.
That's behind you, Nick.
Can you tap twice if that was you?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Keep your feet really still. Ask again, Dave.
Can you please tap twice as a sign of yes?
That was one behind Nick.
Two. Okay. Right, let's just check it. Did you die here?
Yes. Okay. Ask if it's Billy.
It wasn't Portsmouth. Is your name Billy?
Yes. Are you picking any of this up?
Yeah.
You're hearing it.
Can I ask you? I hate to say this, but is it Wells?
Yes.
Yes.
Three for that. What does that mean?
Well, his name's Billy Wells. I was reticent to say it because it's my name.
Wells?
Yeah.
Oh, it's going mad.
It's also, I've got like a couple of cousins though, which is why I was kind of staying away from it. You know?
No, not touching it.
I was wondering if it was touching this rather than the floor.
Ask Billy how many other spirits are here to count down.
Can you tell me, please, how many other beings, how many astral beings are here?
Six.
Okay. Can you ask him if he will do something else for us? Tap twice if he can.
Could you please do something else for us? Tap twice if you can.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Was it him who threw the coin earlier on?
Billy, did you throw the coin earlier?
No.
Does he know who threw the coin?
Yes, he does.
Let me just ask you for it. Can we ask? Yeah. Billy, can you tell me? I know that you, actually, I think you were only playing earlier with me because of my background. And that's fine. Billy, can you tell me, are we in any danger here from anyone else?
A positive plethora of new information coming in there, a real flurry of it. Our historian Leslie Smith is here. She's working hard, even as I speak, to validate it. And you can give us your opinion too. Let's go interactive with Julian.
Thank you, Paul. And interestingly, there's two nights never the same on the show. And tonight, lots of premonitions coming through on interactive. Claire and Wrexham shocked to hear a voice beside her as she logged on to the Most Haunted website earlier this evening. The voice said, "I go there, Norman Finch, remember me." Could this be significant, she says, tonight. Ian in Worcester has a feeling that the name Herbert will be significant this evening. Carl in Skirmersdale thinks there'll be a lot of electrical disturbance this evening, especially with the crew's equipment, so we'll see what happens there. Mandy in Rotherham thinks that a young gentleman is really going to scare Yvette and Kath tonight. She also thinks that David will channel this gentleman later in the show. And Georgina from Derby is sure the team will connect with a 29-year-old woman named Jane, who is distraught. Lots of those coming in more later. Let's look at the webcams. Really, really busy. They're up and running on livingtv.co.uk. And webcam one, the stairs to the first floor. Let's have a look. Alison in Stamford says she could see a dark figure that was leaning over one of the team as they stood at the foot of the stairs. Sarah in Liverpool says she saw a white mist at the bottom of the stairs to the first floor. It kept appearing and disappearing. It's very, very freaky, she says. Webcam two in the education room. Let's have a look. There it is. Tiffany in Hertfordshire says she saw a face by the dark chest in the education room. He was old-looking with long hair. And Jordan from Sussex says she heard a screeching noise coming from the whiteboard as if someone was dragging their nails down the surface. Horrible noise, and spotted on webcam two. Webcam three, Andrew from Norfolk, he says, "I've seen two figures at the bottom of the hallway there. It looks like they know each other and they're waiting for someone. He can't make out their faces, but they are tall." And a trend here, Thea from Plymouth, Anna from Cambridgeshire and Ellis from Sussex have seen mist moving along the corridor there. And finally, webcam four. Let's have a look at that one. There it goes. Claire and Angie and Lincoln are hiding beneath their duvet because they've been totally freaked out by a figure moving slowly from the bottom left-hand corner. They say, "Carry on the good work on Most Haunted Live." Now, our competition, here we go. This is your chance to win. Two winners could be driving off with an absolutely amazing prize tonight. We're giving away two brand new Peugeot Luddick Snake scooters. Yes. And 10 runners-up of Most Haunted Live Volume 4, which isn't out until May the 22nd. The crew will sign these DVDs for you if you're a runner-up. Two winners later in the show, but let's get the question. What is the name of the famous ship that sank near Portsmouth? Was it A, Mary Lily, B, Mary Daisy, or C, Mary Rose? Know the answer? Dial me. 09015 339910. Or if you're a digital satellite viewer, press your red button on the remote control right now. It costs £1. You must be over 18 to enter, and the lines open at midnight. Keep your psychic art coming in, by the way. We're trying to compare and contrast pictures we've got of spirits that are supposed to haunt the Royal Marines Museum with your psychic art. The fax number, all importantly, 0239 273 9495. Or go to the website, livingtv.co.uk. And don't forget, you can now get Most Haunted on your phone. Let's just do that. There we are. You can see Yvette. We've got ringtones and even the theme tune available now as well. All you do to get details on that is text HAUNTED to 88010 and follow the instructions. Each item costs just £1.50, so that can be rather fun. I wish you well with that. And more from Interactive a bit later on. Paul, back to you.
Thank you, Julian. And I know what you're thinking. What else is going to happen on tonight's investigation? Well, to find out, you're going to have to stay tuned. Back in a moment. Welcome back to Most Haunted Live on our final night broadcasting to you from Portsmouth. Yvette and our investigations team are at the Royal Marines Museum. Let's get an update from them right now. Yvette, over to you.
Thanks very much, Paul. We're actually just walking through now into what's called the education room. Now, this room, again, is completely different. Big open spaces, some doors in the middle, quite sort of bare, a few pictures on the wall. But you sense it might be active.
Yeah, there's something. For me, it's like a tumbling energy. About it's probably it gets colder. The energy's here, but it's like a great big tumble. It's a fight. It's people fighting.
Like a nutshell.
And it's just constant. It's like a constant ball of energy. So I can't interact with it. Do you see what I'm saying? Because it's just tumble, 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 tumble. But I'm trying to get what the fight's about.
And who's fighting?
These are Brian Regan's fighting. They're fighting. Not as in like it's nothing to the death, but there's just a negative energy here of a fight, and I can't get my head around why.
And can you see these two soldiers fighting?
I think there's more than two.
Really?
There's two or three at least. At least three, I would say.
So it's got a big punch up. Big argument, big punch up that's happened here in this room.
Yeah. And I think as a result of it, somebody may have died. As a result of, you know, because they play hard, don't they? You know? Because they live hard, play hard.
Uh-huh.
And so there may have been an accidental death. Yeah.
All right.
Have you got a period for that?
I can't really tell you, Steve. It's not. I can't seem to interact with it because it's not.
You're picking up on the energy rather than what you're actually.
Yeah, there's no consciousness.
Okay. So what we might pick up in this room.
Negativity.
Would be from the emotions from that particular fight.
Anger.
Okay.
Those sorts of things, yeah.
Now, Steve, you picked up something earlier on. When we were picking up the taps, earlier on, we were communicating with the supposed spirit of Billy. What happened temperature wise?
I was standing a little way back and I was taking the temperature 2 feet to your left side. And the temperature was going between 20.9 and 31.3. But interestingly, it seemed to be doing it in time with the knocks. I went back, I've been back to the area, I've rechecked the temperature, and there's nothing wrong with the machinery.
So what do you think it is?
I've no idea.
David, sorry, you apologise. I just need to interrupt here, because I have a problem with Billy, and the fact that he's here. Number one, you asked the question and said, did you die here? We've got two taps. Which gives me the impression he died here in the building. You can find out more about that. But I also have a problem with the fact that he's another rank, is he not? And there's something with this building that I can't fit in with it.
What do you mean?
I need to know.
What do you want to know?
He's a private soldier, and I need to know why Billy's here in this building because of the nature of this building, without giving too much away.
Because you shut the rest down. Where else is he going to go? You shut the rest down.
What do you mean?
Well, everything here is now here because everything out there, people live in. You shut it down. So this is all he has.
Gotcha. So he's attracted back here because this is...
This is all he has of his regiment. He's passionate about his regiment. He's passionate about what he does. Where else is he going to go?
I see.
And is he here all the time, Billy? Or do you think he comes in and...
I think he comes in and out.
Okay. Let's walk on a little bit more and see what else we can pick up. And maybe with this negative energy in this particular area, let's not go too far. I think we should stay in this particular area, because if there's negative energy here, then maybe if we call out, we might pick up on something else.
Yeah, bang on.
Do you want me to call out or do you want to call out?
Yeah, call out.
Okay, everybody stand still. Everybody stand still, please. Hello, Ian. Oh, we've got our audience member. Hello, hi, you all right?
Yeah.
Okay. If there's anybody here, any spirit person here, any astral beings that would like to talk to us, Billy, if you followed us, please give us some sort of noise. There you go. He's right underneath us again. It seems to be... I'm sorry, Nick, but it seems to be always round you.
Yeah.
There it is again.
That was there.
It moved down, yeah.
Billy, if this is you, can you knock twice? That was three really quick din din din, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Can you hear that?
Yeah.
Are they getting that in the studio?
It should be. I don't know if you can hear that. I'll try and get close.
Okay, I'll ask again. Billy. Okay. Billy, please can you knock very loudly for us? Two big knocks if that's you. Can you try harder? Please make it louder for us so we can all hear you, Billy. Are you with us now?
It's a dog, I think.
Yeah. Please make another noise in the room. Can you try and move something? If there are any... astral beings here. Billy, if this is you with us, please do something else. Try and show yourself to us or touch one of us. Affect one of us gently. Push something. It's very, very faint. You can hear, basically, underneath the floor. You can hear it, but it's very, very faint, which is really frustrating. Billy, can you answer my question? Just knock twice for me, as loud as you can. Are you angry? Again, please, Billy. Please knock again. Thank you. Can you knock twice for me, if that's you, Billy? Yeah. That was two very faint ones. Okay. You alright?
Yeah, I'm fine. Okay. Just a bit on edge.
Are you?
Yeah.
What, is this because of this negative energy in this room, or of the... You alright?
Yeah, okay.
What?
No, it's okay, just... That's just how it affects me sometimes. It's because I think half of me is concentrating where I am, and the other half is trying to...
You want to go upstairs?
Yeah, I do, but I don't want to leave anything unturned.
Okay. Let's go on a little bit more, yeah? Ian, if you come out with anything, just shout out, yeah?
Do, yeah, definitely.
Okay. In the dark corridor into another room here.
So, Ian Shillitoe and Julie Staniland, our audience member, have arrived. We had a big result, though, I thought, there, from Steve Preston, our paranormal investigator. A temperature differential of 11 degrees. Now, I could see you rock back at that. Yeah. You're impressed by that, kid?
Yeah, I am. Steve Parsons, he was picking up using equipment. I'm always looking for some sort of objective measure of phenomena. The taps I'm always very suspicious of. I just basically don't get it. I think there's lots of natural explanations. But to get it tied in with this 11-degree difference... It's huge. I mean, if it's a degree here and there, you know, you could say it's something to do with outside temperature, that sort of thing, and bodies coming in, change it.
That's a big difference.
But it's 11 degrees, and it's altering, according to what he's saying, in time with the knocks.
We've impressed Kieran O'Keefe, ladies and gentlemen. Come on, that's good. Also working hard for us, we have our resident historian, Leslie Smith. Here she is. Give her a round of applause. Leslie. With another variation on the hair, they're looking very nice. We've had a lot of information, but it's going to be coming through in bits and pieces, dribs and drabs. What have you got for us in no particular order there?
What's very difficult about it is, of course, ghosts are being seen in military uniform, and there's just one or two thousands of those who've been there. And although it's a Victorian building, of course, they were actually formed in 1664 under Charles II. So we can hope we may get some early history link. The man with the dark rings around the eyes, unshaven, I suspect is going to be at the foot of a lot of the difficulties. I was there today, and I haven't been in a room that they haven't got to yet, that's at the top of the building, that's more distressing in my life, and I know why he had rings around his eyes.
And you don't feel you have any psychic powers, or are you sensitive to that kind of thing?
Sometimes we are, sometimes we're not, aren't we? It depends how we are in ourselves. I would say very largely not. But I have to say that what's waiting for them at the top of the building, I suspect, is at the floor of some of this. I'm looking at Billy Wells as well. I found American Marines. Of course, that uniform's quite different. And I'm trying to see if I can find this explosion, which I should be able to find. But my grave concern, if you excuse the pun, is the top of that building. That man, unshaven, with the dark ringed eyes. I think they're going to have a bit of trouble there.
And you're still going to be looking for a Billy W or a Billy Wells?
Absolutely.
And that 1950s explosion?
I'm going to go for all that. I'm going to go for the explosion. I'm still going the name of the man with the rings around the eyes. I'm going for that at the moment. The White Lady, not really. I haven't got much strength there, not from children either. That doesn't mean anything other than oral tradition, of course. That's what we're talking about.
OK, more from Leslie later on in the programme. We're going to take the shortest of short breaks, back with more Most Haunted Live after this. Especially warm welcome to our friends watching via FTN. It's their first night with us tonight. Now you know what you've been missing. This is Most Haunted Live, coming at you for the final time from Portsmouth. Yvette Fielding and the team have been down in the Royal Marines Museum. They experienced the strong energy of conflict in the education room. We're going to find out now where they are and what they're getting at this moment. In fact, I'm hearing we're getting slight problems on our OB. We can't explain why that is. So instead, I'm going to ask Julian Clegg to tell you how you can get involved in tonight's programme and go interactive.
Interesting, Paul, because a lot of people have been in touch about technical difficulties tonight. I mentioned this earlier because access fell off the air and we've had a problem there. Here's another one. Shane in Hone thinks the spirits could have something to do with tonight's technical difficulties. He's worried it could become a theme of the night. I do hope not, but thanks to all of you being in touch about that. Carmen in Dewsbury is totally spooked because her boyfriend predicted did everything right last night, including the cannonball in the coffin. Carmen's boyfriend senses the team will meet a Lancelot this evening. That's interesting. Now, photo messages coming in thick and fast. Thank you for those. The number, by the way, I'll give you that in just a moment, but let's have a look at some now. This is the first one. This is a part of our experiment. Can you tell me or draw for me what you think the spirits look like in the Royal Marines Museum? Here's one. No name on this, so when you send me a photo message, do say who you are and where you're from, but it looks like a military uniform. Thank you. The next one, Diane in Preston has sent this piece of psychic art in, but we've got the military uniform there. Thank you, Diane. Sue from Birmingham has sent us her psychic art and says the gentleman is about 35 years old. With little hair. And Sophia from Newcastle took this photo of her two sisters in the garden. Only after they had the photo developed did they notice the orb. You can see it just there next to their faces. Now, psychic art, this is part of our experiment. I've got some pictures which I'm going to show later of people who are supposed to haunt the Royal Marines Museum. Will your pictures tie in with my picture? I wonder. Here's one here. Gentleman we think is called Peter. This is from the Midlands Ghost Research Society. A vet will be approached by this man, they see. Amanda, Martin, Julian, David, thank you very much indeed for that. Here's another one that's come through. This is the man on the staircase. Thank you very much indeed, Colin, in the West Midlands for that one. I think that one's quite similar in a way to this one here, which has come in from Tracy in Gloucestershire. This guy's got a pigtail as well. This person was in my mind. I tried psychic art, and that's what I've come up with. And will this lady come through tonight? That's what Becky says from Doncaster. That's her psychic art there as well. So thank you very much indeed for that. If you want to send in psychic art, we'd like to hear from you. The fax number, all importantly, here it is. Fax number 0239 273 9495. Or if you just want to text me a message about what the spirits are and describe it on a text, it's quite simple. You text haunted space EXP for experiment and the number is 83088. More on that a little bit later on. Let's go back to Paul.
Thank you, Julian. And I'm going to hand the baton here at Most Haunted Live right over to Yvette Fielding. We can go live now, I hope, to the Royal Marines Museum in Portsmouth. Yvette, how are you doing there?
Fine, thanks very much, Paul. I hope you can hear us. I don't know what's going on, whether it's something here. I mean, Steve will back us up here. We're having an lot of sort of peaks and troughs with energy and electricity.
It's on the temperature, it's on the electrostatics, and it's on the electromagnetics. It's going up and down.
Which may be.
Well, tell me what happened. I don't know what happened to you.
It would be a really good explanation for it.
Okay, well, that's paranormal or...?
I haven't seen any other explanations, easy explanations yet.
Okay.
Okay, come
now,
nearer.
This is just a corridor off the education room. We've actually left Ian Shillito and Ian Cash there together. They've got a walkie-talkie. Hopefully, they'll be picking something up. Okay, now we're just going to squeeze through the storm. We've got to go down some stairs. What are you picking up? Thank you. What are you picking up as we come down here, David?
My ears have popped.
I think it's really like pressure change. Oh.
We're coming down towards the cellar. God, can you smell that? It's just a really horrible, musty...
Okay, Billy. You're here. I can
dank.
Feel you.
It actually
you've
affects
got
your
to
chest.
Communicate with me because I don't fantastic. Know what happened.
Yeah, you can. How does everybody feel coming down here? How do you feel, John?
Oh, tell me what happened, please.
Okay. Use your telepathic. It just feels nasty down here, doesn't it? It's dark and damp and oppressive.
Okay. How does everybody else feel? Richard, how
don't
do you
like
feel?
This.
You don't like it?
It's damp, depressing, cold, and I don't know, it's worth
bedroom,
part of our building.
2 days ago.
Okay, are we all right to go on, guys? Yeah? Carl, how are you feeling?
I came down here just a minute ago when you were upstairs on my own, and I could swear I could hear sort of breathing. And I came out to see if anyone was here, and no one was here, but it's like a...
Oh, let's get in then. Let's turn our torches off. Let's be really brave. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. How dark is this?
You holding my hand?
I'm holding your hand.
Anybody near?
Don't anybody put your torches on. Because the more scared we get, the more energy we create. Therefore, we might hear something.
Oh, sorry.
One of the riggers standing in the corner. Okay. You sense anybody down here? It's in here. What? Did somebody just do that? Was that you?
Well, breathing. Yeah, that was me. I was breathing. I was just
okay.
Having a psychic breath.
I'm just looking in here. What's in here?
You're right.
It's weird.
Oh, what's that?
I heard that. What was it?
It's Richard.
Okay. Should we call out?
Yeah.
If there's anybody here, any spirit people here in this building, I know you can hear me. Please, can you come towards us here? We're in the cellar, in the basement. Please give us some sort of sign. Can you throw something? Everybody stand still upstairs as well, please. Stand still. If there's anybody here at all, any spirit people, astral beings that would like to talk to us, please give us some sort of sign. You all right?
No, I just touched me in the back.
Yeah? Who's here then?
Something just prodded me in the back. If there are any astrals present, please make yourself known.
Did you hear that?
What was that, like a high-pitched...
No, what? It was like a groan, a deep, horrible, menacing groan.
Have you got
I
it?
I thought I heard that.
Have you got
head.
It?
Yeah.
Can we rewind it?
They're recorded back at the base.
Okay, what did you see, Carl?
I didn't see anything. I just used that. I thought I heard a...
You heard that?
Yeah.
You don't want to be...
I thought it was either this rustling or something, but that's not on anything.
Okay.
I think upstairs has come downstairs.
Who, Billy?
No, I think this is what it was waiting for us upstairs.
Oh, it's come down here.
And I can't get a real fix on it because when you get something negative, sometimes the energy presents itself. You know, you hear me often say eyes and teeth. And that's how it presents itself initially.
I think I'm right in saying that they can hear that in the studio. I'm not quite sure.
Good.
Oh, they've definitely heard it, yeah. Okay.
Oh, wow.
Call out, David.
If there's anyone here, even if you're not normally in this cellar, anyone in this building, any astrals, please come forward now. Please show yourself. Touch one of us. Affect us.
You heard banging?
I did hear a bang. I thought it was somebody moving. I'm missing that.
Is anybody walking out there, Carl?
Nobody's walking out this way, no.
Okay.
Please make a louder bang if that was you, sir. Oh.
There you are.
I heard that.
Yeah. We don't want it to be the flipping banging rapping show. We want it to be show yourself. It gets so frustrating.
We're getting those energy spikes here.
You are.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, right.
Can you see those?
It sits around one, and then when David calls out, I see them jump up through.
Take your torch off.
Turn your torch.
Do you want to try now? See.
Can't see it.
No.
Can't see it. There you go. So yeah. What does that mean?
I don't know.
Do you want me to call out?
Call
when
out.
David calls out, he's been jumping up again.
Get more aggressive. If he's aggressive, this person.
If there's anyone here who wants to talk to us, if you're down here and you want me to help you, then talk to me or do something in the room. I will help you as much as I can, but I need to know more about you. I know you want me to call you, sir. I'll call you, sir. I'll call you anything you like. As long as you
I heard that.
Give us some sound or some light. Do something to show us you're here.
Tap, bang.
Please, I can see you're in pain.
Shh, that was a loud one. You can see he's in pain. What do you mean?
Well, he just looks in pain.
Is this the guy that was kind of all hunched over?
Absolutely, yeah.
Any name with him yet?
Not yet, no.
Oh, come on! Do something! Do something else! Come on! give us some sort of sign that there's no you around. Talk to us. See all these men down here? Give them a good push. Give them a whack. Come on. Do something.
What was that?
Gee, are you sure? Okay. Come on, please talk to us.
Some strange smells, you know.
That's because you stood next to Richard.
Thank you so much.
I'm joking.
You're all huddled in the corner.
Yeah, you are huddled in the corner. Why are you all huddled in the corner?
I don't like it.
You don't like it?
No.
What's up? You all right?
I've just gone in there to get out of the way, to be trying to be quiet. And I've just gone up to somebody in the corner, because to stand next to them, and I'm on my own.
There's no one in there.
There's no one in there.
Quiet, please.
Whoa, what the fucking hell was that then?
No, it's you. It's somebody putting a hand on your head to check.
No, I've just been kicked in the shin.
Eh?
I've just been kicked in the shin.
What happened to you?
As John walked through, John got there, but as soon as he got his position, something actually kicked me right at the side there.
Most Haunted Live from Portsmouth, where Yvette and the team at the Royal Marines Museum, before the break, something was heard in one of the rooms. David got a nudge, and there was a noise which Kieran, our parapsychologist, our kind of resident sceptic, you looked at me immediately and said, you heard that. What do you think you heard?
Well, I definitely heard kind of a breathy sound. I mean, I'm putting a name to it, but I heard something, and then John verified that he had heard something on his equipment. The thing is, it could be a number of natural explanations. It could be cable dragging on the floor, and then the acoustics of that chamber has created a sound akin to breathing. It could actually be somebody in the room breathing themselves.
We have got the footage, though, and I would just say before we hear it that I actually wouldn't think it would be a cable, simply because our team have been working so hard and know exactly what they're doing for so long now that I think we should maybe rule that out. Here, though, for you to make your own minds up, folks, is twice in a row that particular moment. Let's take a look.
Who's here then?
Something just prodded me in the back.
If there are any assholes present, please.
Who's here then?
Something just prodded me in the back.
If there are any assholes present, please make yourself known.
Did you hear that?